You've probably learned a lot about the Bible lands through this film, but we'd like you to know the main message of the Bible, which is salvation through Jesus Christ. The Bible says that you can know for sure that you are on your way to heaven. And we'd like to just explain to you some things in order for you to be able to know that you are on your way to heaven. The first thing you need to understand is that you are a sinner. The Bible says in Romans chapter number 3 and verse 10, as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. The Bible here is telling us that nobody is without fault. None of us are perfect. In Romans chapter 3 and verse 23, the Bible goes on to say this, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible defines sin as the transgression of the law. When we break God's law, we've sinned. And the Bible says here, for all have sinned. There's not one human on this earth that is not a sinner. Now, the reason you need to understand that there is none righteous and that we are all sinners, is because of this. In Romans 6:23, the Bible says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The first part of that verse tells us that there are wages for our sin, which is death. The word wages means payment. It's what you earn. When I go to work, I earn money. But when I sin, what I earn is death. Now, when the Bible talks about death, it's talking about more than just a physical death. In Revelation chapter number 20 and verse number 14, the Bible says this, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Here we learn about a second death. See, when the Bible says that the wages of sin is death, it's not just talking about a physical death. The physical death is just the first death or the initial death. But then when an individual gets cast into the lake of fire, that is the second death. In Revelation 21:8, God actually gives us a list of who's going to hell. He says, but the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters. And then he goes on to say this, and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Now, the reason that God gives us this list of really bad sins, murderers, whoremongers, sorcerers, idolaters, and then at the end, he adds a sin that we've all committed when he says, and all liars. He's trying to explain to us that there is none righteous. No matter how good you are, you're not good enough. In fact, James chapter number 2 and verse 10 kind of puts it all together. It says, for whosoever shall keep the whole law and yet offend in one point, he is guilty of all. The first thing you need to understand, and what I'm trying to explain to you, is that we're all sinners. And because we're sinners, our sin has condemned us to hell. Now, you don't have to go to hell, and God doesn't want you to go to hell. But you need to understand that you are condemned to hell, and you need to be saved from hell. Romans 6:23, the first part of the verse said, for the wages of sin is death. The second part says this, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The Bible explains that God has a gift he wants to give you, and that gift is eternal life, and it's through Jesus Christ. Now, there are some things you need to understand about this gift. In Ephesians chapter number 2 and verse 8, the Bible says this, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. It says, not of works, lest any man should boast. The Bible tells us that gift of salvation is from God, and it's not of works, meaning you don't have to earn it. Today, many people believe that they have to live a good life in order to go to heaven, or they have to repent of their sins in order to go to heaven, or maybe they believe they have to get baptized or go to church. But the Bible tells us that the gift is not of works. You don't have to earn it. You don't have to pay for it. Now, because it is a gift, someone did have to pay for it, and that person was Jesus Christ. In Romans chapter 5 and verse 8, the Bible says this, but God commendeth his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. The message of the gospel is that Jesus came to this earth. He lived a sinless life. He never sinned. He died on the cross and was buried, and he resurrected from the grave 3 days later as a payment for our sin. Now, there are a couple of things you need to believe about Jesus. You can't just believe that he was a good man or a prophet. You have to believe what the Bible says about him, which is that he was God in the flesh. John 1:1 says this, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." Later on in the chapter, in verse 14, he says this, "And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth." Now, that only begotten of the Father is, of course, Jesus Christ. John 3:16, the most famous verse in the Bible, says this, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." The message of salvation is that Jesus, who was God in the flesh, paid for our sins, and he offers us the free gift of eternal life. Now, there's one more thing you need to understand about salvation, and that is that it is eternal life. In John 3:16, it's called everlasting life. In John 3:15, it says that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. The first part of John 3:36 says, "He that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life." Now, what that means is that when God gives you salvation, it will last forever. It doesn't mean that you're going to live on earth like some sort of immortal, but what it means is that when you die physically, you will not die the second death of being cast into the lake of fire, but you'll go live with God for eternity, and it will last forever. Titus 1:2 says this, "In hope of eternal life, which God that cannot lie promised before the world began." See, the Bible says that our hope for eternal life is that God cannot lie. Once he gives it to you, he'll never take it away. Now, that doesn't mean that you can live on this earth, you know, without any consequences. Of course, we know that on this earth, there are consequences for sin. We reap what we sow, and God chastises his children. But there's nothing you can ever do that would cause God to take away your eternal life. God wants you to be saved, and he tells you how to do that. In Romans 10:9, he says this, "That if." Now, he says "if" because you get a choice. He says, "That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus." But it's more than just saying words. He says this, "And shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved." See, the gift of salvation has to be accepted. And the Bible tells us that in verse 10, "For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation." Verse 13 says, "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." If you believe what I've showed you from the Word of God, if you believe that you're a sinner and your sin has condemned you to hell, but Jesus came to this earth, was born of a virgin, lived a sinless life, died on the cross, was buried and resurrected as a payment for your sin, that you don't have to earn it, you don't have to work for it, all you have to do is receive it. And once you have it, he'll never take it away. Then God simply asks you to, by faith, call upon him to save you. If you believe that, I would like to help you word a prayer. Now, this prayer in and of itself does not save you. It's the faith in your heart that saves you. But if you believe it, just pray with me and repeat after me. Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner and I deserve to go to hell. I'm confessing my sin to you and receiving your gift of eternal life. I'm not trusting in myself. I'm only trusting in you. Amen. If you've prayed that prayer, I'd like to congratulate you on receiving the gift of eternal life. Thanks for listening.